Today we're playing a brand new game called Scanner Sombre, and this is probably the most interesting looking game that I have ever played simply because of the concept alone. It's totally different from anything you probably have ever seen on my channel, and I'm excited to play this. This is by Introversion Software, and essentially in the game you are exploring this underground area. You're using a LIDAR, which is a light detection and ranging scanner, to aid navigation, and then you must make your way through these very complex networks of underground caves in complete darkness in an attempt to make it back to the surface. Your LIDAR scanner produces millions of individual light points, like you can see here on the screen, that kind of gives you a reference to the surrounding area. These light points paint a static neon 3D image of the environment as you trek through the darkness, but not all is as it seems, and you might not be alone. That is the thing that got me when I read that, is that you might not be alone. So I really have no idea what to think is going to happen in this game, but I'm really excited to find out and play it. We're going to play a bunch of different, we're going to have a bunch of different videos on the game, and I'm really excited to bring those. So just full disclosure for you guys, this is a sponsored video by Scanner Sombre, but I want you to know that just because of that, that does not really change my thoughts in this game. I haven't ever even played it, but I can tell you just from seeing what I saw, it looks extremely interesting. Okay, here we go. We're in some, looks like a tent of some kind. It looks like we've got some items here on the ground. Can I pick up anything? Nothing, okay. It's extremely dark, but up ahead here is something flashing. Oh, man. So, it's like virtual reality. I'm assuming that this game might be for VR, but I am not using VR, obviously. Okay, prototype installed. Scanner. Hold left mouse to fire. Sweet. Yo, this is gonna take a lot of, wow, that is so cool. I could see how this would be amazing for VR. This is gonna, okay, so I'm painting the rock. This is gonna take a lot of getting used to. Holy crap. This is so cool. Guys, I have been talking for, I don't know how many days now, weeks, about how I really want to get a VR, HTC Vive or something, because of things just like this. So here's the real question. We're going to try to make our way back to the surface, but how do we... This is just so cool. What an awesome concept. How do we know if we're actually going the right... Like, how am I got to scan everything so I don't miss a tunnel or something. And you're not alone. What happens if we... Oh. Deep is this for thousands of years. Look at that. Look at the web. You can kind of see the what we've left behind so far. I was utterly alone. No call for help would ever reach the surface. Oh my gosh. This is terrifying. Could you imagine being in a situation like this? My friends all told me I was crazy. My wife couldn't understand my obsession. So this guy just wanted to go as deep as he possibly could into the Earth's surface. But how did he get down here in the first place? But I had to know if the myths were true. Oh, I don't like that. I don't like that one bit. I don't like anything that says, well, I wanted to know if the myths were true. I don't like that one bit, guys. It's just so cool, like... So you can see like how it's green right here, right? Green and red and orange. But if you look back, it's all blue. I wonder why that is the way it is. So I don't see a health bar or anything, so I'm assuming maybe I can't die. Maybe is the game designed to be jump scare-ish? So I'm putting out light effects all the way down there. This is so awesome. And it looks like we've got... Can I run? I slipped a little bit there. So that is the way I need to go. See, that's my main concern is I gotta scan everything just in case I don't, you know, just in case I miss something. This is freaking crazy, man. See, this is the thing. I have no idea what to expect from this game, and every time I play a game like this, all I think is gonna happen is jump scares, and it just freaks me out, man. It's all I can think about is jump scares. Just jump scares constantly. Okay, where do we go? Here we go. We found it. I think this is the... I love the colors. Just kind of fills... The closest to you fills with red. Yeah, you can't ever, like, not... Oh, what the heck is that? What is this? Oh, look, these things are projecting for me. There's a pathway. It's filling this, it's painting this entire room. Whoa. How? Whoa, that's so cool. Okay, so obviously there's some kind of... This looks like some kind of mining... Oh, what? No, it's a... Look, it's like some kind of great hall type of looking thing. Pedestals and stuff. Okay, so here's a bridge. Let's go up here. We've got something beeping, too. Another aperture control. Use mouse wheel or Q and E to change aperture. Oh, you can change the focus of it from narrow to broad. Could this place have been even older than the legend suggested? That's scary. The resolution of science, never before had such a powerful geological scanner been available. Okay, we've made it. We jumped the bridges. You can look at the web. Look at down there. You can see where I came from. That's so cute. Cool. That's so cute, guys. I think this is the way to go. Obviously, it's telling it. Although there was a cave. Oh, look at that. That is cool, man. So sweet. There was a thing behind it, though, which kind of makes me feel like they want you to go this way, but you're not going the right way. Look, I think these are pillars, aren't they? These aren't stalactites. These are actual pillars. So we are going up. I'm getting some static or something. It's a freaking body, yo. I kind of like the tight grouping there. What is this? It's a statue of some kind? Or a dude frozen in time? I thought it was turning to me. It's kind of freaking me out a little bit. Doesn't it seem like it's turning to me? No, I don't know. It's freaking me out though, man. It's making me nervous. I'm watching you, dude. Whatever that thing is. It's a statue, I think. Oh, it looks like we got a drop down here. Point of no return, I guess. We're going this way. No way to get out. Dead end, if you know what I'm saying. Man, I'm so freaking... Okay, so we've been playing the game probably for 5 minutes. I have to assume... Oh, nice little tight corridors. Look at that. You can see all the way down. I have to assume that if there was a jump scare, they wouldn't do it this soon. Do we go down? Looks like we go down. You know what I mean? Like, whoa! Okay. I don't think I can die, but it's making me nervous. There's another post. Here we go. Here's some more. This area seems a little different. So this is kind of just like a how far out do you want to see, basically. The interactive things are like highlighted in yellow. Oh, what? Right mouse button or Z to zoom. What? Sweet. Look at that. There's like bridges all the way. Oh, that's a broken walkway. That's kind of nerve-wracking. And there's even more Alright, these are ropes holding this all together here. That is a little trippy, man. So you can see this is like kind of carved out here. It actually looks like, I mean, obviously somebody's been down here. But how, people haven't been down here for thousands of years. What are we, in the future or something? Or what's exactly going on here? Okay, so you can hear the creaky wood. All right, we obviously can't make that jump, so we have to jump down here. Gosh, I hate doing that type of stuff. We obviously can't go that way, so we have to go this way. Jump! Oh, it's making me nervous, man. I don't like jumping in any game. Never have, never will. Looks like a big mine thing. You know what? Like a bunch of different buckets or something? What an awesome room, though. Alright, let's zoom that back out here. Craziness, man. Can we fill up? Let's just see if we can. It's just gonna kind of get a. Oh yeah, we didn't go really. Look at how big this cavern is. Part of me wants to fall off and see what happens when I die. Part of me actually wants to see if we can survive this whole thing. Here's a walkway going up. What do we got here? Okay. We're onto something. That looks like I can't jump that. That's cool, man. This game's gonna be kind of difficult to choose thumbnails for, you know? Everything kind of looks the same. So we gotta make sure we see some really cool. So we were following these pillars, looks like. Yeah, you gotta really make sure you find some really good stuff, I guess. So where the. Okay, this is. Maybe it's where we go? Maybe not. Where do you go from here? Is there another pathway? Is there another tunnel? Or does it want us to go that up the stairs? I kind of feel like that's where we have to go. So, is there another walkway or something that we're missing? Where the heck are we? Are we supposed to attempt to jump this? That seems very risky. Alright, let's try it, I guess. Nope! Mistake! I don't think I can go anywhere. I think I might be stuck. We might have to. Oh no! What? I found it. Okay, that was it. Oh! Why with the scary noises, eh? Why with the scary noises? Okay, that took me a little bit of time to figure out. They never did iron out all the glitches. Took me a little bit of time to figure out that, but hopefully you guys are still with me. It's most likely going to be an unedited series. Sometimes you'd see sensor echoes from days earlier calibrating turn to ghost. What? I don't know what any of that means. Like the different light particles or something? But even so, I never could explain everything I saw. That blue is kind of hard to read. I don't know if it's just me. Screw that room, dude. I don't ever want to go back there again. It was a puzzle. At the same time as a death trap. I thought I was like aimlessly gonna wander around for days and days. Okay. Looks like this way. Back the way we just came. No, we're going this way. Forward. Always forward. Oh yes. So we had like kind of a jump scare there. I guess if smarter people are supposed to get through that in like 10 minutes. I was gonna say, like, sometimes it seems like most jump scares happen, like, around the 10-minute mark in games. Okay, so we've got another chasm. Like a rock here. no bridge or anything. Oh my gosh. There's a narrow ledge going all along here. And there's one going along here. Oh, screw this, dude. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Hold on, man. Keep scanning. Oh, the narrow ledges. Holy smokes. Holy smokes. Stop with that. Stop with that. That was a guy falling. Look at that. What? This is like electronic feedback like you'd get from a phone or something. No, do we need this glitchiness happening? No, we don't, we don't, we don't, we don't, we don't. Jump! Okay, we made it, we made it. Now I'm going all the way back over here for whatever that little tiny thing was that I was obviously supposed to get it. We don't need glitches. Quit it. Quit with the ghost stuff. It's that ghost thing they were talking about. Okay. Okay. This is what we have to do. Creep along the edge. Could you imagine doing this in VR? It'd be terrifying. I'm pretty sure this game is a VR game. Oh, screw that, dude. Now we gotta go all the way back. Hopefully there's an exit over here. Burst scan. B to initiate burst scan. Whoa! That is awesome. How cool is that? We got a save marker. Guys, that's where I'm gonna leave it for today's video. Hopefully you guys are having a great day. Things are going well for in your life. There's a gigantic chasm here. What now? What do we do now? Join me in the next one to find out. Hope you guys are having a great day. I will see you next time.